I will be just rolling. If you have question or if you can't understand anything, you can just stop me. If not, I'll just go on. Okay. I assume you already gone through it. I just categorized them as a primary, secondary, tertiary, trading, e-commerce. And I think you're aware of what is a primary sector, secondary sector, tertiary sector. In a business environment, business economics, you're taught with this, right? I'm sure. Yes or no?
Yes, sir, we know it.
Sir.
So direct, yeah, direct yes, business. Yeah, one is directly doing business. Indirect business means they are not directly responsible for doing business, but they are associated with business. They're part of the business. The examples I've given is are trading, e-commerce, investments, and so on. Okay. Then size of the business. When you look at the size of the business, categorize them into the presence a business has, irrespective of ownership or organization structure, where it is, that will tell you the business size. A local company, a small computers vendor to our college, okay, he is from Vijayanagaram or Vizag, that you call him as a local. Regional means limited to the city or region, you can call this regional company. A national company, people who have presence across the country, we call them as a pan-India presence. National company, you can call them as, or pan-India company. Then international companies are those people who have some association with foreign suppliers, foreign customers, through sales or inventory, inputs or raw materials, whatever. Then multinational company has a clear concentrated business center in a foreign company. Okay, like if you take TCS, it is an MNC. If you take Infosys, it is an MNC. If you take Wipro, it is an MNC. You take Reliance, it is an MNC. You take Airtel, it is an Indian MNC. Similarly, foreign MNCs in India, Sony, you take Apple. Apple is not in India, it is yet to come. So out of America, Apple has many subsidiaries. So international companies are different from multinational companies in the sense multinational companies have their own independent subsidiaries in foreign soil, that we call them as multinational, more than one country usually. So global company is bigger than a multinational company. I think iPhone is a global company nowadays. McDonald's, Coca-Cola, Pepsi, Reebok, Nike, most of the FMCG brands, they are global companies. So why they are global, why they are MNC, why they are local is the span of business, the reach of business makes them local, regional, national, international, multinational or global. Then business ownership, based on business ownership, you can call them as public sector, private sector, joint sector, society. What is joint sector?
Owned by government and private individuals.
The national insurance.
The Maruti.
Exactly. That is a best example of joint sector. Private sector means 100% or majority of the stake is with the private people. Public sector means 100% or majority of the stake. Majority means what percentage?
51%.
Majority stake in a company. Correct. So that is public sector. Societies means owned by cooperative societies. Let us talk about business organizations. Irrespective of ownership, irrespective of types of business, how a business is organized. That is quite interesting. That is where our today's session lies. Okay. So you can read out that, but this is what I wanted to give you. When you talk about a business organizations, you have different varieties. One is for-profit organizations. The other one is not-for-profit organizations. Any idea where does a college fall?
Not-for-profit organizations, sir.
Good. Within that, A, B, two are there.
B, sir.
Within that, one, two, three are there.
One, sir.
So I don't know, it was a guess or you mean it, you are perfectly right. It is a trust. Most of the educational institutions are under the legal framework of trusts. Apart from that, broadly, we have for-profit organizations working purely for profits, and other sector, you have not-for-profit organizations. Though they make money, profit is not the motive. Income is not the motive. Something else they have in their mind. I'll tell you that. So in profit organizations, you have individual firms. I think we will discuss one by one. Individual firm means an individual, independent human being, a person. He or she starts the business, owns the business, organizes the business, runs the business, manages the business, or even set of people. More than it could be more than one also. So in that you have sole proprietary partnership. Okay, so this is purely individual firm. Means till the time a person is alive, business is alive, the organization is alive. The person passes away, business dies, organization dies. And there is no difference between filing the income tax returns of that person and business. It is the same. That is an individual firm. Then I think most of, if you have known people running a shop or something like that, yeah, they have this kind of organization. I think these things you're already aware. Some interesting things you can read quickly. Okay. So nowadays, new companies, students, young minds like you who is willing to start a company, they are not starting a sole proprietary. They are doing a startup as a private limited or some other form. But still, there are some people. Here I give an example. In the olden times, every new business, big business started as sole proprietary. There's a idea of starting, giving the example of Coca-Cola here. Go through it. If you have a question, ask me. If not, I'll go to the next one.
Yes, sir.
So why it is difficult to raise capital here? How do you raise capital? What are the sources of capital?
Friends, family, and all. Maybe.
What is the type of capital, Magna?
Sir,
I think you answered one of the sessions. There are basically two, right? Types of capital.
Equity and debt.
Right. So here I'm saying, in sole proprietorship, the major disadvantage is difficult to raise capital. Why is that so?
Because here the owner will mostly prefer equity capital, I guess.
But you can ask friends, faculty also, no, to lend you. So owner is only one. You are right, perfectly right. But you can also ask your friends to lend money.
Yes,
like
sir.
You borrow from bank. You can ask your bank also. Reason here is, so it is risky for a person to give huge money. Okay, at small business it is okay, but it runs into several lakhs or crores. I think no one will come forward to lend you. That's a major disadvantage. Okay. Then next one, partnership. I think almost the same, but quickly go through it, all of you, please. I think these things are already given to you. Can you tell me what is the major difference between proprietary and partnership?
Sir, here more than one person is there, sir, in partnership business. But in sole trader, there is only one.
Yeah, the risk is shared by more people rather than one. That makes easy to run the business. That's a major advantage. Okay. Can we go to the next one?
Yes, sir.
Partnership, you have two types in India or anywhere. Names will change, but these things will. Partnerships can be registered, and it is a choice to you. You can run the partnership business without registration also. That is unregistered, you can call it as. And the other one is, what do you call, a registered firm with a registrar. Okay, fine. And you got the details if you want to start your company with a partnership deed. You can check the Register of Firms website, or you can go to Register of Companies website. There you can get the link of Register of Firms. It's quite easy. Process also gave you, if you want to start a company, this is very easy. Two of my ex-students, for them only I prepared this. They had a small startup and they are going for public limited, private limited kind of, they're having big plans. After looking at this PPT, they got a consolidated idea and they stick to their own ideas. But they have had a concrete process with a consultant. So process also I gave you, you can go through it. Some of the major examples, it is just partnership, but the companies are so big. I think in the last class on Tuesday also I was mentioning about this company. It is such a big company. Actually, it started as a sole proprietary. After his name is Cargill. After he passed away, his family members became partners of this company. Still, it is a partnership company right now. It's a family business with partnership. Okay. Then individual companies. Then second one is second B category is private companies. Okay. So how many are there in private companies? How many types I gave you in the list?
Three, sir.
Three. What are they?
One person, one company.
These are those three companies. One person company, limited liability partnership, private limited company. In US, UAE, Europe kind of places, it is, they are known as LLCs. In India, they are known as LLPs. Okay. Instead of starting a sole proprietary, you can start as one person company and others. But before that, how an individual becomes a company, these are the advantages and disadvantages. You can check that. Let us see one by one these three. One person company, check the details please. See, this is going to be a kind of Bhagavad Gita for rest of the sessions for all of you. We will be talking about all these things in future sessions. Please be careful and minded. Save this PPT or share the link. This is very important. If you don't understand anything, please, this is self-explanatory. These for your understanding here. Unless and until you ask me, I cannot explain you. Make a habit of asking something if you don't understand. That's quite important. Yeah.
Sir, then what's the major difference between sole trade business and one person company?
You can look at the advantages here. In the case of a sole proprietor, sole trader, it is limited life. Okay, it is limited life means that the business dies. Got it?
Yes, sir. Yes. But
in case of OPC, one person company, the person can change, but the company is alive. Similarly, in the sole proprietary, liability is unlimited. For example, I was asking you, major disadvantage of sole proprietary is banks will not try to give you more and more money to you. Okay. Even if they have given, if the person defaults, what happens, you know, the bank will not just claim on the business assets. They may take the seizure of the personal assets of the sole proprietor. Means liability is unlimited. They can take the home, take the car, take the refrigerator, take the TV, which is personal. It is not related to business. There is no difference between business and person there. But in this case, liability is limited. Bank which has given loan to a one person company cannot say that give me your car, give me your house. No, it is not a business named asset. It is a personal asset. And it becomes a little easy because rules and regulations, norms are good. It attracts clients, lenders, and others. Okay? And major disadvantage is, there is only one tax. Personal income tax, business tax, both are same. But in this case, the person has to pay both personal income tax as well as corporate tax. Double taxation. Okay.
Okay, sir.
This is OPC. Then the requirements, if you want to see, it is very easy. Everything is online. If anyone is interested, you can check these details. I've given the references also. Importantly, Ministry of Corporate Affairs, MCA portal gives you the whole information. MSMEs, startups, OPCs, society, trustees, FDI, FPI, everything is there. You can check that. How to make a PAN, I think the process I clearly gave you. Yeah, you can follow the process. Form INC32, it is available in MCA portal. You can download it and submit it. Then you have to submit memorandum of understanding, then articles of association. Then you have to upload all these things into MCS portal. Then you also have to upload into ROC's portal, Register of Companies. Once these things are done, legally, you get the permission. Okay? You get the number. You get the DIN, everything. Okay. Then in future, if you want to convert this into private limited and others, yes, you can do it. Okay. So major advantages I listed here. So see, these advantages and disadvantages here I gave you for all three kind of companies. Okay. But here later I gave independent advantages of OPC, LLP and so on. I also gave the comparison. As Meghna was asking, you can check the comparison here. I did that. I forgot actually. So with numbers, I gave you the whole thing. Some examples are also I gave you how they are successful in the name or in the form of OPC. Then limited liability partnership, it is an extension of partnership firm. Please read it quickly. What we do is quickly surf the pages. Major things we'll discuss. So actually it was introduced in 2008 and the salient features of the same is given to you here. So what happens if LLP is converted into a private limited company? What happens? It is winding up. What is the implementer mandatories in case of changes? That is also given to you here. If you go to the websites and other things, it is a little confusing and tedious to read tens of pages. So this will help you a lot. The benefits I gave you here, I think there is a comparison also. Please check the comparison here.
Yes,
Lalita,
sir.
You are not responding. Only Meghna is responding. Please do that. Tanuja. So next is the third one in private companies is PLC. What is the previous one?
LLP.
Limited Liability Partnership, sir.
LLP. Okay, now this is PLC. Quickly read and tell me what is the difference between an LLP and PLC. Okay, LLP is just limited to partnership, but PLC is one company. It is similar to a public limited company, which I will tell you now. Okay, public limited company, which is owned by a set of individuals, like partnership, that you called as PLC. You will understand more when we talk about public limited company. Okay, let us see. So I gave the differentiation here also. Now the real thing is, we all are aware of these companies, public limited companies. Any example of public limited company?
Sir, BPCL,
NTPC.
Yeah,
HPCL.
Any listed company is a public company. Apart from listed companies which are traded, listed in National Stock Exchange, Bombay Stock Exchange and so on. Apart from that, there are also unlisted companies. Like for example, Air India is a public limited company. It is not listed. There are many companies like that. Okay. So you will find the difference there between a public limited company and a listed company. Then within this public limited company, within this public limited companies, you have unlisted company, listed company, multinational company. You can broadly categorize. Unlisted company is just a public limited company, but not listed in NSE or BSE. Okay. And multinational company, listed company is listed in NSE. Multinational company is a public limited company. It could be listed or not listed, but operating out of the country. That you call it as multinational company. I think there is in the international finance subject that is more important for the students to understand. Unlisted companies, as I told you, there are shareholders, but the shares are not listed and they cannot be traded. That's how it goes. Okay. Fine. Then there are relative advantages and disadvantages. Okay, our focus is not there. Okay, our focus is on which companies, can you tell me, for this course?
All companies.
There are specific names I have given, no?
Sir, limited liability company.
Yeah. Starting with sole proprietary, partnership.
Sole proprietary. Yes, sir.
One person company.
One man company and limited.
Yes. One man company, limited liability partnership. Then after that, turn.
Public limited.
Private limited company. Before that. Okay, I'll show you the whole picture. Let me go to the broad picture. It's the first one. I don't know how to move. I'm not getting. Okay. I'm almost there. Where is that classification? Yeah. I think this individual firms are more important. Okay. After that, private companies are important for small business. It does not mean small businesses cannot become public limited companies. In future, they may. But our focus is on small business. So for that, individual firms and private companies are the major resources. The first one is sole proprietary, second one is private partnership, third one is OPC, fourth one is LLP, fifth one is private limited. So you should tell me, if you are starting a small business, you can consider any business. I will not ask you which business. Okay. If you can mention, sir, this is the business I want to start. I will randomly pick up anyone. You should tell me what is your business and which form of business organization will you prefer. Okay.